So action items for you.
Yeah.
Is you have these two different worlds.
By the way, though, he fixed it. He's doing great now. So.
I love it. You have these two different worlds. You have the work. You're super honest. You have the home. Everything's great.
I mean, at home, here's the thing is, I believe we need to be honest. I'm not an ethics class here for you. I love to be honest. I'm just trying to say at work, you have to be totally candid, just direct.
Mm-hmm.
This kick, hug. Good, bad, black, white, none of that. Well, you know, you sort of did an okay job, like you mentioned.
Right.
But at home, if you bring that mess home,
yeah.
I mean, you might, when you get home, you don't want to just walk around there.
I feel like if you were preaching the kick, hug method to your wife, you might lose some people.
Yeah, I'm just telling you, I got yelled at last week because I did some stupid things.
Yeah.
And it's just because I'm so used to being candid, I come home and I'm just unleashing a candor cannon, and I'm like, I hate myself right now. So, anyway,
that's enough on candor. There, we got it.
Yeah.
There we go. So let's move on here to the next step. Get the right people on the team. Okay, get the right people on the team. We got a notable quotable from Jim Collins, best-selling author of Good to Great,
Good to Great,
Built to Last, and other books that are quoted quite often.
Yeah.
He says, get the right people on the bus and get the wrong people off the bus.
Hmm.
What does that mean?
Well, what happens is you have a bus. If your business was a bus,
mm-hmm.
It could be a different kind of vehicle, but if it's just a big bus, there's different seats on this bus. I prefer to have one of those flat buses, it's totally flat in the front. Anyway, if this is your bus, there's all different seats in this bus.
Mm-hmm.
And you need to find the right people to be on each seat of the bus.
Right.
So you need somebody to sit back here, you need somebody to sit up here, you need somebody to drive, you need somebody to help do the maintenance, you need those people.
Mm-hmm.
But if they don't serve a right task on, if your bus already has a driver,
right.
You don't need two drivers.
No.
You got to just say, hey, driver, you got to drive somewhere else.
Right.
But a lot of businesses, I see businesses where they've got 17 drivers,
right.
No passengers, and it's not working. So just be real. Does that person have a place on the bus or not?
Well, and how often have you seen people that should be off the bus, the person with the drinking problem, the person that is perpetually late, somebody who can never get that deadline on time, but they're still on the bus.
Yeah. Well, here's the deal. John Rockefeller, the world's wealthiest man during his lifetime.
Right.
There's a quote I'd love for you guys to put on screen when we edit this, but it states that a friendship based upon business
mm-hmm.
is worth much more than a business built upon friendship.
Hmm.
So the whole idea is if you start a business with your friend, probably not a good idea sometimes, because once you start handling money, some of you watching this right now have been partnered with a friend, and once you started partnering, you noticed your friend stealing money, your friend not being honest, your friend being hardcore about not paying you. But when you go into business with somebody and you see how they handle money, you can become great friends.
Right.
So it happens a lot of times in most American businesses, because again, most people watching this, you have 10 employees or less.
Yeah.
If you have 10 employees or less, chances are, your wife might be working with you.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, here's a tough one. Years ago, I had a guy I worked with who his aunt did his books, did his bookkeeping.
Yeah.
And she was stealing money.
Mm.
His aunt. His aunt was on drugs and was taking money. But he's like, well, she's a good lady. She's going through some things. It's hard for her to keep it together, but I'm trying to help her. And I wish that was unique.
Right.
I've probably had 4 or 5 clients where I've dealt with somebody who has substance abuse or theft issues,
right.
But they're related to the owner, so they can't be fired. And the business just gets stuck. And are customers coming back because you double charge them? Mm-hmm. No, they're going to file a lawsuit and move on.
So what practically do we do here?
What you have to do is you have to make sure that you ask yourself this question, yes or no. Does this person need to be on my bus? If the answer is no, move on as quickly as possible before the heartstrings get firmly attached.